So now we have two hypotheses and we like to test them. The null hypothesis is the basic hypothesis that something is correct. And unless proven wrong, we always believe the null hypothesis is actually correct. We trust the manufacturer. But we have sufficient evidence that with very high likelihood the null hypothesis is wrong and the alternate hypothesis is correct. Then we reject the null hypothesis and we tell the manufacturer, please print the label on the box because your number there isn't quite correct. So let's do it. To recap, we have in our sample 11 yeses and 4 noes, and our null hypothesis equals p equals 0.9, and our alternate hypothesis is it doesn't work as well as advertised, so p smaller than 0.9. This is already exactly the setup we're going to study when we make hypothesis tests. If we look at the sample, then it's obvious this is binomial, which is the fancy word for coin flips, binary experiments, with 15 different experiments and under the null hypothesis, a probability of 0.9. So obviously, in this binomial distribution, there are about 16 different outcomes from 0 to 15. The most likely is 13. 14 is also pretty likely if the null hypothesis is correct. And then the probability goes rapidly down. The key is assume that H0 is actually correct, so the probability is 0.9. Then find what's called a critical region, under which 5% or less of the total probability of this binomial resides. Put differently, you will place a marker over here that separates outcomes that invalidate the hypothesis and outcomes that validate the hypothesis, so that all the outcomes together left of this marker collect in totality at most the confidence level, in this case 5%, so that if you find an outcome that sits to the left of this point, you can say, wow, this outcome was so insanely unlikely under the null hypothesis, I just don't buy it. If conversely the outcome is somewhere in this green box, then it isn't that unlikely after all. Realize that each outcome itself might have a slow likelihood, but you don't care about the probability of the outcome itself. Even the maximum likely outcome has a small probability in this model. All you care about is putting a separator between an acceptance region and what's called the critical region. And again, the logic is the critical region collects many possible outcomes, but in totality, these probabilities don't exceed the 5%. So if the final outcome is in the critical region, you can confidently say, wow, I'm really surprised. I don't buy that H0 is correct.